哎，哈利路亚！各位兄弟姐妹，我们继续以清洁的心来继续聚会。
Hallelujah, brothers and sisters, we shall continue with a pure heart to worship God.
同心默祷。
Let us say a silent prayer.
阿门。
阿门。
奉主耶稣圣名，继续安息日黄昏的聚会。
In the name of Jesus, we continue with our Sabbath service.
我们唱赞美诗四百二十九首。
Let's all arise to sing hymn 429.
眼睛已经看见主降临的大阳光，他正除尽一切不为罪恶死亡和殉葬，他已抽出他的圣洁，化作闪闪的光芒，主真理的降临，永远永远哈利路亚，永远永远哈利路亚。
大家同心祷告。
Let us all in one accord kneel down to pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚！ 亚，感谢主耶稣，阿门。奉主耶稣圣名啊，正道。
In the name of Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
Relying on the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们大家继续来啊，进入但以理书第九章的信息。
We continue with the message of the book of Daniel.
啊，上次我们看到但以理书第九章有两个重要的信息。
In the last session, we read that there are two important messages in the book of Daniel.
一个就是但以理的啊，悔罪的代祷，悔改的代祷。
The first one was the intercessory prayer of repentance of Daniel.
那在这个代祷当中，有一个很重要的、很特别的信息。
In this prayer of intercessory prayer of repentance, there is a very important message.
就是但以理把自己放进祷告当中。
That is, Daniel put himself in this prayer.
他跟百姓，他说他跟百姓、跟以色列国都有罪，他自己也有罪。
He said that both he and the nation of Israel have sinned.
他不是站在一个高高在上的圣洁属灵的代祷者替有罪的人祷告，不是这样。
He did not sit in a high and mighty place to pray for his people.
他虽然在为耶路撒冷祷告
，although he was praying for Jerusalem，
在为以色列民祷告
，he was praying for the nation of Israel，
但是他把自己也放进去。
But he put himself in.
那第二个重点就是我们今天要靠着圣灵来帮助来讲解的。
The second message is for us to rely on the Holy Spirit to explain this.
就是七十个期的预言。
That is the prophecy of the 70 weeks.
这个是但以理书中其中一个非常非常复杂、非常困难解释的一段意象。
This is a prophecy that is most difficult and complex to explain.
但是我们靠着圣灵帮助。
But relying on the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们可以用很谦卑的心，很简单的。来看这个意象，来看这个预言。
With a very humble spirit and with a simple way, let us look at this prophecy.
你就发现到其实也不是很复杂。
Then you discover that it is actually not that difficult.
因为圣灵在带。
Because the Holy Spirit is leading.
因为谦卑。
Because of our humility.
因为单纯的心。
And because of our simple.
你用复杂的心哦来看这一段哦，你越看越不明白，越看越乱的。
Because if you use a very complex faith, the more you read it, the more you will be confused.
所以在网上你看那个外教会的解释，很多书籍的解释，这一段非常混乱，非常多的解释。
If you were to read other church materials, then you tend to be very complicated.
好，我们来请翻开但以理书九章。
Let us turn to Daniel chapter 9.
我们读24节跟20到27节。
We read from verses 24 to 27.
一样传道带领读中文的24跟25节。
A preacher will lead you to read the Chinese verse 24 to verse 25.
那英文是26到27。
The English version will read 26 to 27.
一二三。为你本国之名和你圣城已经定了七十个期，要止住罪过，除尽罪恶，数尽罪孽，引尽勇毅，封住异象和异元，并高至圣者。你当知道，当明白，从处令重新建造耶路撒冷，直到有受高君的时候，必有七个期和62个期。正在艰难的时候，耶路撒冷城连带接待壕都必重新建造。26节。
Verse 26, we read the English. And after the 62 weeks, Messiah shall be cut off, but not for himself.And the people of the prince who is to come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary. The end of it shall be with a flood. Until the end of the war, desolations are determined. Then he shall confirm a covenant with many for 1 week. But in the middle of the week, he shall bring an end to sacrifice and offering.And on the wing of abominations shall be one who makes desolate, even until the consummation which is determined is poured out on the desolate.
Amen. 好，那二十四节我们看到神已经定了七十个期要发生的事。
In verse 24, we have seen that God has already determined what is to happen.
已经定了，意思就是说不会改变的。
It is determined means it will not change.
已经定了，就是说神会按照他的心意、他的旨意进行，一直到应验为止。
It is determined means God will establish it according to His plan until it is accomplished.
那么这个要发生的事情呢？神分三个部分来组成，分三个时段来发生。
What is going to happen? God divided it into three phases.
第一个，好，第一个就是叫做七个七的时间，七个七的时段。
The first section is called the 77.
第二个就是六十二个七的时段。
The second phase is the 62:7.
第三个就是最后一个七的时段。
The last part is the 1:7.
所以加起来哦，就是七十个七了。
So if you were to total them up, it is 77.
那么神定下这个七十个七的目的到底是为了什么呢？
What is the purpose of God determining this 77?
我们不需要去那边猜测的。
We do not have to guess.
因为圣经自己就给我们答案了。
Because the Bible has given us the answer.
神定下这个七十个七的目的就是为了显明和圣城已经定下了这七十个七 的事情。
The reason why God determined this 77 is for His people and for His holy city.
那无论是为了本国之民，就是显明，还是为了这个圣城，就是耶路撒冷，就是神的国啊，就是为了神的国、神的民、神的家来定的呀。
Whether it's for the people, that is the Israelites, or for the holy city Jerusalem, it was determined for the house of God.
所以这个重点你不要模糊掉。就是对准神的国，就是今天来讲是对准真耶稣教会来说的神的国嘛，末世的真教会就是神的国、神的家、神的显明嘛。
So let us not be muddled with this. Whatever it is for the true church and for the people of God in the last days.
那七十个七其实只是一个象征数目，好像启示录很多的那个数目是象征性的。
So this 77 is but a figure, just like in the book of Revelation, there are many figures.
啊，就像主耶稣说的，你要饶恕对方七十个七，表示说你要无限量的饶恕他，不是说你算到七十个七了，哦，就停了，不是这样。
Just like Jesus telling his disciples, you must forgive them 70 times 7 doesn't mean that you have to count until 70, but it is an unlimited number.
注意哦，七十个七都是一个象征性的时间而已。
Please take note that this 77 is but a time.
再来
，Next，
七十个七这个时期这个时间点呢，重点不在它的日期跟时间，不是。
So this 77 is not about the time or the place.
重点是在神在这个时段里面，他要完成的事情，他要进行的事情。
The crux of the matter is what God wants to establish or accomplish during this period of time.
这才是重点呀。
This is the focus.
可是很多研究圣经的学者呢，传道人呢，把时间太多注重那些日期跟时间，一直去算，一直去算，来斗来斗踢，来这个补漏了又补那个，补那个又补来补去，结果都偏漏了，也偏差了。
But many scholars of the Bible or many theologians, they tend to explain this according to the time. As such, they are not able to fill in many gaps.
因为时间那个日期不是重点，重点是神在这段时间时段里面他要做什么呀？
Because the exact time and the period is not the important thing. What is important thing? What is important is what God wants to do during this period.
就是传道刚才开始就说我们简单一点，不要太复杂，意思就是这样。
Just like I say at the beginning, we shall try to simplify and not to be too
complicated. 你不信？你看那些很多的解释，包括我们教会一些人的解释，太注重时间点的时候，很乱啊，因为时间斗不起来啊。但是硬把它扯上来，又硬把它解释下去，结果你发现到很矛盾的。何必这么复杂呢？
If you were to understand, to hear the other explanation of the other preachers or other churches, you find that these weeks need not to be too determined on the time. We don't have to be so complex.
都说了，这些时间点，这些七十个七、六十个七七，就是一个象征数、象征性的时间点而已。
So this period, this is only a period of time.
再来。
Next.
在这个七十个七的预言当中。
In this vision of the 77,
我们发现到神的祝福要临到我们世人。
We know that the blessings of God will come on the people of the world.
我看到七十个七的预言里面，这是最大的预言，最大的祝福啊！神要进行最大的工作，就是祝福要临到我们。Amongst
all the prophecy, this is the greatest prophecy, and in this prophecy, God wants to bless us.
所以二十四节一开始讲七十，定七十个七的时候，一开始就讲祝福，对不对？一开始讲就讲有六种福气要临到我们。
In verse 24, the beginning of this verse tells us that all there are six blessings that is about to come upon.
这个是七十歌曲里面的很大很大的重点啊，很大很大的福音啊。
This is a great message and a great gospel in this 77.
第一个福气。
This the first blessing.
神要止住罪过，有没有？
God wants to finish the transgression.
罪过就是指显明常常背叛神所犯的罪。
Transgression is something that the Israelites constantly transgress against.
神要止住，就是说不让这个事情啊，这个行动继续发展下去。神要停止它。
God wants to finish off the transgression. In other words, He does not want it to continue anymore.
因为以色列人常常犯罪。
Because the Israelites constantly transgressed
the law. 因为以色列人没有办法遵守法律律法，没有办法遵守律法。
They were not able to keep the law.
没办法遵守律法，就是要被定罪，要被审判的，那是很。 很可怜的，不是可怜了，就是很凄凉，就是了。
If they are not able to keep the law, then they would have to be put to death.
因为在神的律法上，没有人可以得救啊，因为我们没有办法行律法，没有办法。Because
under the law, no one can be saved.
所以第一个福气说，神要止住这种罪过。So
the first blessing is God wants to finish.
不要让这些事情、这个行动继续发展下去。God
does not want all these to continue to happen.
那神就要有一个方法来止住罪恶喽。
So God has this method to finish the transgression. We shall see later.
那第二个祝福是什么呢？
What is the second blessing?
第二个祝福就是要除尽罪恶。
The second one is to make an end of sin.
除尽罪恶就是说你不再有罪，你本来有罪的，但是你不再有罪了。
To make an end of sins means you will no longer have sins.
你本来有罪的，现在你已经没有罪了，因为你的罪被除尽了。
Originally, you have sins, but now you do not have sins anymore because it has been washed away.
所以你不可以再犯罪了。That
is why you cannot sin anymore.
这个是第二个祝福要领到。This
is the second blessing that will be given to you.
第三个祝福。The
third blessing.
要赎尽罪孽，看到吗？
To make reconciliation for iniquity.
哦，这个赎尽罪孽就是说，预言将来会有一位永远的大祭司。 要为选民、为百姓献上赎罪祭。
This is to prophesy that in the future there will be this eternal high priest who will atone for our sins.
他自己要来替我们赎罪，要献上自己。He
himself will atone for our sins with his own life.
蒙神悦纳，蒙神赦免，因为他代替了我们。This
would be acceptable to God because he has replaced us.
哦，那除尽罪孽哦，圣经的罪孽多数是比较严重的。 那些暴行啊，那些杀人啊，等等的欺压罪啊，比较严重的罪。So
this iniquity would refer to something that is more serious, serious offenses that Israelites will commit.
请注意哦，当说除尽罪孽这个罪孽的时候，不是一般的小过犯，不是，是严重的罪。但是神说，有人要替我们赎罪。
This iniquity is not something that is serious, something that is lightly, but God said that somebody will replace us to do this.
在这个全世界，在这个世界里面，谁有资格替我们赎罪呀？谁呀？
In this world, who else has this power and ability to atone?
没有一个人有资格的。
No one else has this.
因为他自己也是有罪的，他要替我们赎罪，他自己要被神审判的，他怎样替我们赎罪呀？
Because they themselves have sinned, and how can they atone for us?
所以当时这个预言哦，是大家莫名其妙，谁呀？谁能够成为无罪的替我们赎罪呀？谁呀？他们没有办法明白。
So during when this prophecy was made, no one could understand because they did not know who else can give us.
谁会想到是主耶稣亲自来神亲自道成肉身？谁会想到这个这件事情，这种方法？谁会想到呢？没有人会想到的。
Who would have thought that Jesus would come into this world to die for us and to atone for us?
当然，我们现在看回去这个预言，这个祝福，我们当然明白了，因为已经发生了嘛。
Of course, when we read back this verse, then we will understand because it has already happened.
可是这个预言一直到耶稣来的时候还有七百多年，知道吗？ 不是七十几年了，是七百多年才发生耶稣降生，知道吗？
But from the time of this prophecy until the birth of Jesus, there was a 700 period, a 700 years gap.
所以谁会明白啊？一代一代过去都没有人会去明白这件事呀。
So who would understand one generation after another generation? No one understood this.
但是啊，第四个祝福。
The fourth blessing.
还要引入永义，引入。
To bring in everlasting righteousness.
引入就是哦，永义就是指人跟神和好的关系。永远的义就是指人跟神的关系和好。
This is to reconcile the relationship between God and us.
那人跟神的关系要怎样和好呢？
How can our relationship be reconciled?
神就是要用救赎的方法把我们引进，用这个方法把我们带进神永远的义里面，要用这个方法把我们带进去永远的义里面。
God wants to use this method to bring us into this everlasting righteousness.
这个就是十字架的救赎。
This is the salvation of the cross.
在当时谁能够去明白？
At that time, who would be able to understand
this? 所以都是奥秘啊，都是不懂的东西啊。
So all these are mysteries, something that we do not understand.
只知道是一个祝福啊，但不知道那个方法是什么呀，也不知道是那个大祭司是谁呀。
We only know that it is a blessing, and we do not know the method, and we do not know who the high priest is.
第五个祝福。
The fifth blessing.
要封住异象和预言，看到吗？第五个。
To seal up vision and prophecy.
要封住异象跟预言，这一句话有两个层面，有两个意思在里面。
And there are two angles and perspective to this, and two meanings.
首先，我们讲封住，封住就是说你进不去了，因为被封住了，你打不开来了。
We talk about to seal up, and when something is sealed up, we are not able to go in, and we are not able to open.
是吗？这个叫做封住嘛。
And that is the meaning of sealing.
你意思说你看不到这个意象，你也听不见这个预言，你进不去。
In other words, you cannot see this vision and you cannot hear this prophecy.
传道就要让你先明白什么叫做封住，就是你进不进，你看，你进不了，你看不到，你也听不到，听不到预言。
So I want to stress this, that when something is sealed, you cannot go in, you cannot see it, and you cannot hear it.
于是这个预言，这个意象被打开了，被掀开来了，我们才能够进入里面，才能够看见，才能够听见。
Right until this seal has been opened, then we can get in and we can see and we can hear.
这是第一个层面。
This is the first angle.
把异象和预言封住，意思说我们现在已经不需要它了。
To seal up vision and prophecy, in other words, now we do not need it anymore.
因为已经应验了，已经打开了，已经成全了，现在把它封住了，不需要了啦。因为已经应验了，今天在我们来看这个预言，这个意象已经预言了，不需要了。
To us today, this has been prophesied, this has been fulfilled. That is why it is being sealed up.
这个六种福的内容，原来就是主耶稣十字架的救赎。
And the sixth blessing is actually the salvation grace of our Lord Jesus.
所以，我们今天现在回头看这个六个祝福六哈，这个预言，我们其实我们现在不需要这个意象了啊。
So if
we were to, 这个预言已经真的不需要了。
If we were to look back, we actually do not need this prophecy anymore.
因为已经成全了。
Because it has been fulfilled.
而且成全到从耶稣钉十字架到现在都两千多年了，成全了两千多年，已经实现两千多年了，你还要这个意象呢？
In fact, it has been fulfilled for more than 2,000 years after Jesus died on the cross. So do we still need this?
这个是封住意象和预言的第一个意义，第一个层面的解释。
And this is for the first significance and the first meaning of this sealing of the vision.
第二个解释。
The second explanation.
什么叫做封住异象和预言封住
？What is meant by to seal up vision?
罪恶没有被除尽。
The sins are not being cleansed.
没有被引入永义里面。
It is not being brought into everlasting righteousness.
然后这个异象、这个预言、这六种恩福，跟你没有关系。
So these six blessings have nothing to do with you.
所以对你来说，这一切的六种福，这一切的要发生的事，对你来说是被封住的，跟你没关系的， so, 你进不到里面去的。
So to you, you have nothing to do with it. You are not able to enter into this vision.
你要看看不见，你虽然在听也听不明白的。
you want to see, but you may not be able to see. But if you want, you cannot even hear and you cannot understand.
因为与你无关啊。
Because it has nothing to do with you.
因为你进不去啊。
Because you are not able to enter.
为什么你进不去呢？
Why are you not able to enter?
因为你没有被神称义，还没有被神称义啊。
Because you have not been justified by God.
因为你的罪孽还没有被除尽啊。
Because your sins have not been cleansed.
意思说，如果你不接受神的福音。
In other words, if you do not accept the gospel.
你拒绝十字架的救赎，这个救赎的方法，拒绝，你不信这个方法。
You reject the method of the cross, salvation of the cross.
这六种福。这个意象这个预言这六种福六种意象预言跟你没关系的知道吗你进不去的
this blessing of this prophecy will not come upon you
虽然你有在听福音啊好像布道会你有在听啊听是听但听不明白的
although you may be listening to the words of God during evangelical service but yet you are not able to understand
有些人自己看啊看意象他也看到意象看到天国看到神迹啊可是看但是去看不见的没有真正看见的梦叉叉的看但是看不清的
Some people they may see visions but even though in those visions they are not able to understand
为什么会这样
Why is that so?
因为这个救赎这个预言这个意象神在他心里已经封住了
Because this
封住他听不到他看不到
This vision has been sealed up in their hearts
不是神要封住他不给他看不是请注意
It is not that God wants to seal it in him
是他自己不愿意打开他的心来接受呀他不接受啊，他不要呀。
It is that person who has sealed it himself and he does not want to accept.
这叫做这个意象封住了。
That is the meaning of this vision being sealed up.
这样明白吗？
Do you understand?
那我们今天为什么可以明白呢？可以看见，可以听见呢？为什么？
Why is it that we are able to understand today? We can see and we can hear.
而且听也听得明白，为什么？
Even when we hear, we can understand.
因为我们的心打开。
Because our hearts have been opened.
我们接受主耶稣，我们相信主耶稣。我们接受主耶稣进来。
We have accepted Jesus as our Savior into our hearts.
所以这个救恩、这个意象、这个预言就打开了，你就可以进去了。
Therefore, this vision has been opened, and we are able to enter.
以上就是对封住意象跟预言啊，传道的解释是这样。
And this is my explanation with regards to this vision.
有两个层面。
And there are two aspects.
第一，已经不需要了，已经成全了，所以封住它。
First,
第一个意思是这样，因为不需要了。
First meaning is it is no longer necessary because it has been fulfilled.
第二个意思是那些不接受十字架救恩方法的，那这个意象你怎样看都看不懂，你怎样听也听不明白，与你无关。
The second meaning is if you do not accept the gospel, then no matter how you read it, you will not be able to understand because it has nothing to do with you.
好，再继续，第六个福是什么呢？
What is the sixth blessing?
第六个福就是。并高至圣者，在原文是并高至圣所，英文是至圣所吗？没关系，你解释。
The last one is to anoint the most holy。
你看我们中文小字哦，中文小字就是原文来的，并要高至圣所，神的殿，要高神的殿。原文是神的殿。
In the Chinese footnote, it is this most holy is referring to the sanctuary.
这是第六个福气。
This is the sixth blessing.
就是神要使圣殿再次成为荣耀圣洁的殿。
That is God wants the sanctuary to be the holy temple of God again.
神要恢复建立荣耀的圣殿，这是六种第六个福气。
God wants to re-establish the glorious kingdom of temple of God.
这第六个福气排到最后面，从第一个福气到最后一个福气，就是神要建立荣耀的圣殿。
This is the last one and the sixth one. That is God wants to establish this glorious temple.
在救恩的过程里面也是这样。
In this process of salvation,
拣选我们。
God selects us,
然后除尽我们的罪孽
He cleanses us of our iniquities,
把我们引进永义神的义里面
He brings us into this everlasting righteousness
到最后的时候呢就让我们建立一个荣耀的教会成为圣洁荣耀的圣殿
And in the end, he will establish us into his glorious church
所以成为荣耀的圣殿是救恩的最后的目的最后的工程
So to establish this glorious temple is the last objective in the Old Testament.
不是神拣选我们啊，赦罪了哦，我们进天国了。不是，到最后的时候，我们每一个人都是神的殿，要成为荣耀圣洁的圣殿。
It is not just that God has chosen us and we are baptized and we enter into God's kingdom, but rather God wants to fulfill, make us this glorious church.
那神就把这个荣耀圣洁的殿哦提到天上去，被带借到天上去，圣殿被提的意思就是这样。
Then God wants to lift this glorious holy church into the heavenly kingdom.
能够被提上去的全部都是圣洁荣耀的，因为是圣洁荣耀的圣殿的。
To be lifted up are those holy saints because they are the glorious ones.
所以今天我们在信仰的功课里面，今天现在要努力做的就是建立荣耀的圣殿，使自己成为荣耀圣洁的一个圣殿，然后被神带上去。
What we need today is to make ourselves holy to establish this glorious holy church. Then we can be lifted up by God to His eternal kingdom.
比任何节目、任何祷告、任何什么哇、什么fellowship更来的更重要。
This is
更加的重要。
This is far more important than any kind of work or fellowship in church.
传道的讲道常，我们不是传道了，讲道人的讲道常常就是要提升我们这个事情，建立荣耀的教会，你一定要成为圣洁荣耀。
This is what speakers would always emphasize. We must establish a glorious church.
所以在道理上是严厉的，但要求上是高的。
That is why the sermons are very stern and the expectations are high.
发现到没有什么人接受得了这样的道理。
But not many people are able to accept it.
因为你为什么不能接受？
Why is it?
你忘了这个事情。
Because you have forgotten this.
到六个福气当中，最后就是要建立荣耀圣殿呢，你忘记了要让自己荣耀圣洁。
You have forgotten that the sixth blessing, the final one, is to establish a holy sanctuary.
你只是停留在罪过被除尽啦，赎罪罪孽啦，引入永利啊，你只是在前面那些福气啊，感谢神啊，圣洁啦。 罪被除尽啊，耶稣就你只是在这前面那一段，你忘了还有最后那一段。
You have only remembered the first section where your sins are being cleansed and you have been brought into God's everlasting righteousness, but you have forgotten the last part.
所以最后一个福，第六个福就是神要高至圣所，让他圣洁。
So the last blessing is God wants to anoint this holy sanctuary to make it holy.
神会帮助我们。God
will help us.
因为这里说神啊。 神要高我们，就神会帮助我们。我们做不到，但神做得到，神会帮助我们的。
Here it tells us that God will anoint us, although we may not be able to do it, but God will help us.
这样我们做一个结论。We
make a conclusion.
70个期的时间里面。In
this 70 times 7,
神要除尽罪恶。God
wants to finish the transgression.
神要引入永义。
God wants to make an end of sins.
要恢复人跟神和好的关系。
Make reconciliation for us between God and us.
并且神要高立圣殿。
God wants to anoint this sanctuary.
使教会成为荣耀圣洁的殿。
That this church will be a glorious temple of God.
当神完成了这些工作旨意时。
When everything has been accomplished.
这个意象和预言就不再需要了。
Then we no longer need this vision and this prophecy.
因为完成。
Because it has been accomplished.
所以就把意象封住了。
That is why it has been sealed up.
就是主耶稣在十字架上说的，成了，成全了，成功了。
And it is exactly the meaning of Jesus saying this on the cross. It is finished.
好，这是六个福气的重点。
This is the crux of the matter of these six.
那现在我们讲第二个重点。
We talk about the second important point.
70个期分成三个部分。 三个时间点来发生。This
77 is divided into three sections where it happened.
第一个叫做七个七。The
first one is 7-7.
7-7是什么时候开始呢？
When did it happen?
从重建耶路撒冷开始。
From the time they restore and built Jerusalem.
看25节啊。
Verse 25.
你当知道，当明白，从重令神发出命令的时候，重新建造耶路撒冷。 一直到有受膏者尼赛亚的出现，这是在七个期时间要发生的事。Know
therefore and understand that from the going forth of the command to restore and build Jerusalem, there shall be 7-7.
那从圣经的历史告诉我们。From
the history of the Bible, we are being told.
波斯王古列出令，发出王的命令，宣布以色列人可以回国重建耶路撒冷，有没有？
Cyrus, king of Persia, set the decree to allow the people of Israel to return to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple.
你应当明白，应当知道，从出令开始，就是王发出古列王发出命令，回国重建圣殿，那个时候开始。
You must understand that from the going forth of the command, the decree set forth by Cyrus, king of Persia,
然后呢，到什么时候呢？
Until what time?
直到弥赛亚耶稣基督的出现。
until the coming of Messiah.
叫做直到有受膏的君的时候，受膏的君就是弥赛亚，主耶稣出现。
And this Messiah, the Prince, refers to Jesus Christ.
那这个是七个七里面要发生的事情。
And this is during the seven seven.
这是第一段。
This is the first part.
第二段。
The second part.
叫做六十二个七。
It is 62:7.
看二十六节。
Verse 26.
注意哦，天使啊啊，不是二十五节哈。
Verse 25. 啊。
直到有受膏君的时候，必有七个七和六十二个七，必有七个七和六十二个七，请注意。
There shall be seven and 62:7.
天使把七个七和六十二个七两个时段把它联合起来，把它加起来，看到吗
？So this angel combined this 7:7 and 62:7 together.
加起来的时候就变成是六十九个七了。
When it is being added up, you get 69:7.
本来是分开的七个七跟六十二个七，现在天使的解释，六个七和六十二个七把它加起来，变成六十九个七，要发生什么事
？Originally, it was separated 62:7 and 7:7, but now the angel has combined them together 62, plus the seven, then you get a total of 69:7.
那在六十九个七的时间里面呢，天使把它讲解成为正在艰难的时候，六十九个七原来就叫做在艰难辛苦的时候。
So this 69:7 is the period of the great tribulation.
那耶路撒冷城连接带壕都必重新建造。
The Jerusalem will be rebuilt.
耶路撒冷要重新建造。叫做正在艰难的时候。
When Jerusalem is being rebuilt, is it called the period of tribulation?
哦，这样就很清楚了。
Then it'll be very clear.
哦，原来很明显的指出，从古列王出令回国，一直到尼希米第三批回国重建城墙，到尼希米。
From the first wave, where Cyrus, the king of Persia, asked allowed the people back.To rebuild the temple until in Nehemiah chapter 3, and the third wave in the book of Nehemiah to return to rebuild the wall.
正符合了天使所说的正在艰难的时候，这个时候很艰难。
It is to fulfill what it is being prophesied that this is a difficult period.
因为一直都有阻挡，有大阻挡。
Because there has been many hindrances and obstacles.
虽然是这样，耶路撒冷的城，包括它的街，连带壕都必重新建造。那就尼希米时代就是应验的，就做完成了这件事。
Although it is very difficult, yet the temple in Jerusalem, the city, and the wall was accomplished, was all rebuilt during the time of Nehemiah.
原来在六十九个七当中，这个时段当中，以色列人分三批回国，分三次不同的时间回国。
So it is during this this period of 69:7 that the Israelites they went back to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple and the city wall in three waves.
第一次
，the first wave，
在主前538年。
It happened in 538 BC.
由所罗巴伯以及大祭司耶稣亚带领。
They were led by Zerubbabel and Joshua.
重建圣殿
，to rebuild the temple，
人数大约是50,000
，approximately there were 50,000 people。
我们没有时间看圣经
了。We have no time to refer to the Bible。
第二次回国
，the second wave of their return，
主前458年
，458 BC，
由文士以斯拉带领
，they were led by Ezra the scribe。
那请问这个重点是重建什么？
At that time, what were they trying to rebuild?
重建信仰。
They were rebuilding the faith.
这时回去的大约2,000多人而已。
At that time, only 2,000 plus returned.
跟第一次回国哦，相隔80年。
Compared to the first time they returned, it was 80 years apart.
第一次回去的时候重建圣殿，到第二次的时候已经相隔时间80年才第二次回去了。
From the first time they returned to rebuild the temple until the second time where Ezra led them to rebuild the faith is a period of 80 years.
这八十年里面，他们的信仰堕落了，腐败了。
And during this 80 years period, their faith has degraded.
本来神让他们回去就要重建圣殿、重建信仰的，来敬拜真神的呀。
Actually, God wanted them to return to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple and to rebuild their faith.
那我们看哈该书、撒迦利亚书就知道了，他们回去见了没有两年，受到一点阻碍，他们就停工了，不见了，然后就把这个家建天花板啊，住到好好、美美丽丽啊，是吗？哈该书就在讲这件事呀。
From the book of Haggai and Zechariah, we can see that upon their return to Jerusalem, they did not continue with, they were met with obstacles and hindrances, so they stopped the rebuilding the temple and they continued to rebuild their own houses.
所以文士以斯啊，带这么一个使命，一个很圣洁的使命，回去要重建以色列人的信仰，他们的信仰腐败了，他们的信仰已经堕落了，已经不行了。
So Ezra the scribe, he had this very holy commission from God to rebuild, to bring the Israelites back to Jerusalem to rebuild their faith.
其实重建信仰，原来也是一样重建圣殿。To
rebuild their faith is the same as to rebuild the temple.
因为圣殿有分两部分，第一个部分，这个神的圣殿，这个教会，这个会堂，神的殿，因为献给神的，这个是硬体的。
The temple is divided into two parts. One is the heart, the physical temple. It is to be sacrificed to God.
但是还有一个属灵的软体圣殿，就是我们人的灵魂生命，这个是也是神的圣殿，要重建我们的属灵的圣殿。But
the other one is the spiritual temple whereby we make the church of God.
在今天来看，重建属灵的圣殿比重建这个物质的圣殿更加重要。So
spiritually speaking, it is far more important for us to rebuild our faith than the exterior of the church.
那个就是第二次回国重建的重点了。That
is the importance of the second return, the second wave of the return.
那第三次回国是在什么时候呢？The
third wave of return to Jerusalem.
就是在主前445年。It's
in B.C.
445. 由尼西米来带领。
It was led by Nehemiah.
尼希米在圣经里面，我们看不出他是什么特别人物，他不过是一个平凡的信徒而已。
From the Bible, we cannot see how important Nehemiah was. He looks like just an ordinary believer.
他圣经介绍他说，他是在王宫里面倒酒的，负责跟管理神王的饮食的。In
the Bible, he was described as being a cupbearer to the king.
一个这么平凡的信徒，却能够这样的关心神的殿，这样爱护神的殿，实在是平凡中不平凡的事，平凡中了不起的事。A
seemingly ordinary man, he is able to do extraordinary things in the eyes of God.
那他回去的时候，他是在重点在做什么呢？
When he led the Israelites back to, when he led the Jews back to Judah, what did he do?
他的重点就是重建城墙。
The most important thing that time was to rebuild the city
wall. 因为圣殿的城墙倒了，有些有裂痕了，有很多破洞了，烂烂的，乱七八糟的。The
city hall, the city wall was in ruins and it has collapsed.
你的城墙倒了或者有洞了，敌人就进来，各种的污秽的东西就可以从洞那边跑进来。When
the city wall has collapsed, or when there are gaps, then the enemies can come in or can come in through the gaps.
这是第三次回国重建城墙。This
is the third time they return to rebuild the city wall.
到底多少人跟他回去？圣经没有记录。How
many people exactly went back with him? It's not recorded
in the Bible. 似乎感觉到圣经的描述都是他个人的，个人带走几个人，一小群人，或者他的仆人，或者跟他一起的。
It looks as though he brought only some of his companions back to rebuild.
那第三次回去呢，跟第二次回去呢，相隔14年，大约14年。Between
the second time they returned to Jerusalem and the third time, the difference is 14 years.
那人数越来越少，回国的人数越来越少，越来越少，到最后是一小群人，一小几个人而已。
The number of returnees were actually decreasing, and until the end, the third one, only a few returned.
很多以色列人都不想回家了，不想回国了。Many
of the Jews did not want to return anymore.
他们的心都在巴比伦。Their
hearts were in Babylon.
都在波斯地。Their
hearts were in Persia.
为什么要回去？Why
do they need to go home?
这里吃好住好，样样都好，而且成功了，有地产，有产业。 有自己的事业，有自己的成功了，回去做什么？
They have a good,
回去做什么？
They have a good life there. They have their own career. They have their own land. They have their own achievements. Why do they need to return?
这是我们从他们回国三次回国中看到一个很让我们悲伤的事情，让我们很警惕的事情。
This is what we can see from the three times they returned to Jerusalem. This is something that is very despairing.
当生活富足的时候，当有成就的时候，当有产业越来越多的时候，钱财越来越丰富的时候，还有谁想圣殿呢？还有谁说要回国关心神的家？谁呀？
When they are so successful and when they have everything in this foreign land, who else would think of returning to Jerusalem to rebuild?
听听就好咯，啊，听听就好咯，听一听哦，这样子，哦，这样祷告咯，那叫祷告，是这样而已咯。
So the most,
然后呢？然后呢？祷告咯。
The most they could do at the time was perhaps just to pray.
那么他们大约用了一百年的时间，分三次回国，大概一百年的时间，你算一算。
So they took about 100 years in these three times to return to Jerusalem.
那么重点呢？这69个器就是发生这些事情。
So the 69-7 is when all these things happened.
当然，在世界还有发生很多很多很多世界的事啦。
Of course, many other things in the world happened during this period.
但是那个不是神的重点。
But those are not the crux of the matter.
神的重点就是说，从出令那个下令回国，一直到重建城墙。这个才是神的重点。
And the important thing here, with God is that they restore and build Jerusalem.
感谢神，这个三个重点就是：第一，重建圣殿；第二，重建信仰；第三，重建城墙。
And the three important things that time when they returned to Jerusalem was to rebuild the temple, rebuild the faith, and to rebuild the city wall.
好，我们来看第三段哦，第三部分就是最后一个期。
The last section, the third section is the last seven.
最后一个器呢，有分成两半。
The last seven is divided into two sections.
就是分前三年半、后三年半，这两半合起来就是最后一个器。
That is the first three and a half and the second three and a half. Add up together, you get the seven.
哦，看27节。
Verse 27.
哦。一期之内，他必与许多人建立盟约；一期之半，他必使祭司以贡献指数。最后一个期里面有分了，前面三一半，后面的三年半分开。
The last seven is divided into the first seven and the second seven.
好，那前三年半哈，请注意啊，前三年半是关系到使徒教会的事情。
So the first seven is regarding the apostolic period.
后三年半呢，是关系到我们真耶稣教会，今天我们教会的事情。
The second three and a half is regarding our church today.
所以我们最关心的就是最后这个七年的事情。
So we should be more concerned about this last seven.
那六十九个七的事情已经过去，已经成为历史了。我们现在读圣经都常常讲回他们的事情，都看回去发生的事。
The 69-7 has already passed, and when we talk about the Bible, we often refer to them. These are the things that have passed.
所以我们今天要关心的，要进入的是最后一个期。
So what we should be concerned of today is the final seven.
那我先讲哦，前三年半的预言的事。
And this final seven, the first of it is the first three and a half.
第一个事情，前三年半就是受膏者必要被剪除，看到吗？
The first three and a half is that they will do away with this anointed one.
在哪里有讲啊？
Where is it written?
26节。
Verse 26.
过了六十二个期，包括刚才天使加清的那个七个期，六十九个期，过了六十九个期，那受膏者必被剪除，一无所有。
After the 69-7, Messiah shall be cut off. He would have nothing left.
这一句预言，受膏者必被剪除，就直接说是主耶稣被杀啊，主耶稣被钉死十字架，主耶稣被杀，受膏者弥赛亚被杀。
Here Messiah shall be cut off. It means that Jesus will be nailed to the cross.
27节。
Verse 27。
一期之内，他必与多人建立盟约。那个他是指谁？主耶稣要指主耶稣跟我们立新的约，与多人立坚定的盟约，不能改变的约。
In this seven, God will establish, Jesus Christ will establish this new covenant with us.
所以六十二个期加那个最后一个期，这段时间哦，最后一个期就是前三年半，主耶稣要成立救恩啊，钉死十字架。
And in this last seven, Jesus Christ will accomplish the salvation plan, where he will be nailed to the cross.
那么他必使祭司以贡献指示是什么呢？
What does it mean that he will end the sacrifice and offering?
是指新约已经产生了，已经发生了功效。
It means that the Old Testament has proven its efficacy.
所以那些祭祀献祭的事情全部停止，不需要了。
So all these sacrifices and burn or, and offerings will cease.
关于二十七节是最难解释的地方。
Verse 27 is the most difficult to explain.
因为你看下看整句呢，又好像这里不是指耶稣跟我们立约，又好像是指那个小脚，那个地基督者的出现来破坏。
Sometimes you read it, it may seem as though it is not Jesus making this covenant with us. It looks as though it is the little horn that is disrupting.
所以传道说我们不用太复杂。
So that's why I say we do not need to be so complex.
因为我们发现到启示录也好，但以理书也好，神的预言哦，常常会有多重性的预言。这件他讲这一件事哦，其实不是单单指这件事，他也重复的预言另外一件事情，常常会这样。
Very often when we read the book of Daniel or the Revelation, we find that every verse is multifaceted. So it does not mean that it refers to that one particular thing.
一件事情的预言常会有多次的发生，多次的重复，叫做多重性的预言。
Every incident that happened will have other meanings and events that follow.
那我就发现到这多重性的预言当中有三个层面，有三件不同的事情会发生。
And in this matter, there are three other matters that will happen.
简单说，他有三个不同的他会出现。都适合用这个预言。
In that sense, that this he, there will be three different persons to refer to this.
第一个他。
The first he.
他必以许多人建立朋业，是吗？
He shall confirm a covenant with many.
这是刚才传道讲的，是指主耶稣成立救恩，跟我们立新约。
Like what I said earlier, Jesus Christ making a covenant of salvation with us.
然后呢，不再献祭了，一切的祭物都要停止了，不用再献祭。
We shall no longer make sacrifices and offerings.
这应该是符合这个预言了。
And this seems to agree with this prophecy.
第二个他。
The second he.
就是指那个小脚，那个地基督出现。
Referring to the little horn, the Antichrist.
他这个地基督呢，抵挡神的呢，他必以许多人坚定盟约，许多人跟从他，跟他立约。
This little horn or the Antichrist will also make covenant with many people.
就是启示录十三章说的受印，跟他立约，打印，我们签约，有印记，有受的印记，打在手上、额头上，跟他签约。成为他的人。
It is like what is written in Revelation chapter 13. Those who are sealed by the beast on their forehead, they will make this covenant with this little horn.
那他出现的时候呢，他会使祭祀与供物停止，就是说不让我们敬拜神，不让我们亲近神，更不愿让我们来奉献给神。
When he appears, then he will put an end to sacrifice and offering. In other words, he will stop us from praying and from doing our service to God.
这个他也是符合这里的预言呢、啊，以多人立约，使祭物停止，也是符合的呀。
So this
完全符合。
So this little horn will also seem to fulfill making covenant with many and to stop sacrificing and offering.
我都相信，我都可以接受，因为两个说是耶稣的立约，或者是地基督的出现，都符合这个预言的要求跟讲解。
Whether it is Jesus Christ or this little horn, the Antichrist, it also fulfills what is written here.
那第三个他是谁呢？
And who is the third he?
这第三个他是比较特别的，是隐藏的意思，隐藏的。
This third one is a bit special. It is concealed.
原来他时候到了，他必以许多人坚定朋约。哦，是指以色列到了神定的日期，以色列要复国，以色列复国的大事情。
It refers to the revival of the nation of Israel when the time is up.
所以以色列在1948年5月14日与联合国签署条约，以多人坚定盟约，与世界联合国来签约，承认以色列国。
On the 14th of May 1948, the United Nations declared the revival of Israel.
就如这里所预言的，他必以许多人坚定盟约。所以也有人把这个呢，坚定盟约应该要把以色列复国放进去，因为在这段时间也发生这件事呀。 真的在历史上这段时间发生这件事。
Because in history, it truly happened that the covenant with many was made like it as in Israel were established as a nation with United Nations back in the.
那到这个以色列复国的时候，不是前三年半，是后三年半发生的事。
When Israel was revived as a nation, it happened during the second, third and a half, three.
所以讲到以色列复国的时候，二十七节。他不是说前三年半，他是讲在一期之内，在这个七年里面就会发生这个事。他没有分前跟后，没有。
So when this happened, it's not specifically mentioned whether it is happening in the beginning or the end.
是不是有点复杂
？Do you think it's a bit complex?
就是啦，所以二十六节跟二十四最难解释，因为他有时又把它分开来，有时讲到那个事情的时候，他又不分开来，又说一期。整七年里面一定会发生这个事，啊，有时候又把它分开来，前会发生什么，后会发生什么，这个就是我们很复杂的问题啦。
Sometimes it appears as though it is to be consolidated. Sometimes it appears as though it should be combined or separated. This is where the complexity comes.
所以传道说，我们简单一点，我们就不要分前跟后。
So that is why I say, let us not divide it into the beginning or the end.
我们就直接看二十节，一期之内，这七年里面会发生这个事，就对了。
So we shall just look at the overall overall 1:7.
好，这样那个他哈，我们看他与许多人建立本业，就已经有这三种的解释，也符合历史的化身，符合圣经的教啊，圣经的启示都符合。
So there are three interpretations as to who this he is in verse 27, and all these three interpretations are according to the Bible.
那受膏者必被剪除，一无所有是什么意思呢
？What is meant by this Messiah shall be cut off？
啊，受膏者是主耶稣吗？主耶稣真的一无所有吗
？Messiah is our Lord Jesus Christ. Does it mean that he will not have anything？
真的，真的，在十字架的时候，主耶稣真的彻底的牺牲自己，成了一无所有，是真实的事。
Truly, when our Lord Jesus was crucified on the cross, he was cut off from God and he had nothing left.
我称他为十字架上的一无所有。
I term it as the crucifixion on the cross and he was left.
在十字架上，主耶稣有三个没有。
In
三种没有。
In before the cross, he had three nothing.
因为这里讲他主耶稣一无所有嘛，他一无所有。
Here it says that he has nothing left.
第一。
First,
他的衣服没有了。
He lost his garments.
我们一个人死了哈，钱财没有了，生命没有了，但是死的时候还有穿一件衣服嘛，穿着一件衣服进棺材嘛，对不对？活着的也会给你穿一件衣服，最少有一件衣服穿在身上，对不对
？At least when we who are living now, when we die, we will have at least the garment on our body when we are taken into the.
遮盖我们的羞耻，不让我们赤身露体啊！虽然死了，还是有一件衣服盖住我们的身体啊，对不对
？To cover our nakedness, so that at least when we are buried, we will still have something to.
请问耶稣挂在十字架上，他有衣服吗
？When Jesus was nailed to the cross, was he wearing any clothes?
他剩下一条衣服，里圣经说的里衣就是里面的衣服，不是外面的，里面的衣服。
He was left with his undergarment.
他本来是有穿里面的衣服，有一件衣服的，最后的就是一件衣服。
He had his last piece of cloth on him.
可是圣经怎么讲呢
？But what did the Bible
say? 那些兵丁把他的衣服内衣里衣把他扯下来呀。
The Bible tells us.
扯下来呀。
The Bible tells us that the soldiers removed his garment.
然后他把它撕开来，分开，一人一块，一人一半，一人一点啊，把衣服撕到碎去了， 撕成一块一块。
They tear apart his garment and divided among themselves.
那等于说，耶稣挂在十字架上，连最后的那件衣服都没有了，遮盖羞耻的都没有了，一无所有。
In other words, when Jesus was nailed to the cross, the last piece of shirt on him was
already taken away. 连衣服都没有，破烂的衣服都没有。我跟你讲
，He did not even have a piece of clothing.
你今天一直呱呱叫说你这个没有那个没有。
Today,
耶稣才是真正的没有。
Today you complain that you do not have this, you do not have that, but it was Jesus Christ Himself who did not have it.
那第二个没有是什么
？What is the second nothing that?
在十字架上，主耶稣第二个没有就是没有了天父，没有了真神。
At that time, at a point in time, Jesus did not have God.
传道，你有讲过龙吗？有讲过分吗
？Preacher, are you wrong?
你没有看圣经了没
？Do you not read the Bible?
你没有听过耶稣十字架七言没
Do you not hear the cries, the seven cries of Jesus before the
cross? 所以主要放弃之前，在十字架讲的其中一句话，就是说：“神啊，神啊，你为什么离开我啊？父啊，你为什么离开我？连天父都离开他，把他走了，不再跟他在一起了。”One
of the seven cries of Jesus on the cross is that, Lord, Lord, God, my God, my God, why do you forsake me?
之前他受痛苦、被十字架、被打，神都跟他同在，没问题的。 神都还在，虽然我痛苦，虽然我受羞辱、受鞭打，但是神，我还有神呐、啊，神还跟我同在，知道吗
？During the trial, when he was beaten and scourged by the soldiers, at least at that time, God was still with him.
直到他挂在十字架上的时候，神都离开他，神也没了。
When he was nailed to the cross, God forsook him, and he did not have God.
你现在神还有，什么都有，你呱呱叫什么呀
？Now you have God with you. Why are you still?
你没有神了吗？神不。 不跟你同在了吗？神不要你了吗
？Do you not have God? Is God not with you anymore?
第三
，the third one，
在十字架上的第三个没有是什么
？What is it that he did not have on the cross？
是什么？命也没了。
He lost his life.
虽然从九点到三点，九点这几个小时早上到下午，还是命还在的。虽然被钉着，很痛苦，在流血，但是命还在的，还有气的，还会讲话的。
Although he was nailed on the cross from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., yet he was still having his life then.
到最后，他咽下那一口气，最后呼吸的时候，命都没有。Then
finally, when he breathed his last, he did not even have his life.
这是真正的一无所有。This
is truly what it is meant by he had nothing.
耶稣真的是很可怜，非常可怜，为了我们，他一无所有。
Our Lord Jesus is truly pitiful. Because of us, he had nothing left.
在700多年前，主耶稣就神就借着但以理预言了，受膏者会一无所有。已经讲了，我们看不懂而已，我们听不懂而已，我们体会不到而已。
700 years before this happened, Daniel already prophesied that it will happen, and it is us who did not understand.
我们再看26节啊。
We read verse 26.
那受膏者必被剪除，一无所有。Messiah
shall be cut off, but not for himself.
那么以后我们再讲，有一个王要来。In the
next one, we will talk about this coming of the prince.
要毁灭这个城和圣所。
To destroy the city and the sanctuary.
还有哦，那个城和圣所好像洪水被冲走。And
this will be likened unto a flood.
有没有发生这种事
？Did it happen?
有发生。It
did happen.
发生在神的殿，神的城被冲走。It
happened in a temple, and the city was taken away by the flood.
那我们应该是星期二晚上继续吧。
We'll continue on Tuesday evening.
来，我们唱诗。
We sing him
352首。
We sing him 352.
他擦我生命，在他爱之深处，他。
Thank our Lord Jesus Christ.
因为我成为一无所有。
Because of me, he was left with nothing.
那目的是使我样样都有。
And his purpose is that I will have everything.
因为要让我样样都有, 他自己成了一无所有。
Because he wanted me to have everything, he was left with nothing.
这样的爱还不够吗?
Is this kind of life insufficient for you? Is this kind of life not deep enough?
你还问, 啊, 爱你有多少?
Do you still want to ask him how much he loves you? Let us all kneel down and pray together.
Phong Chu Yesu San Ming Tao Gao. Hallelujah. Can see Zami Chu Yesu. Hallelujah. Thank you. 感谢主耶稣，阿们。我真相信，我的相信耶稣替我受害，天父爱子这样定是真是难报的恩，我真相信，我的相信，耶稣替我受害，天父爱子。这样定是真是难报的恩，阿门，
阿门。一生都难以报答的爱，一生。
There is no way we can repay the grace of Jesus even in our whole life.
感谢神祝福带领我们安息的聚会。
We thank God for blessing us in this Sabbath day.
愿神祝福大家，纪念大家的敬拜。
We ask the Lord to bless you and to remember you.
聚会到这里结束。
Our service ends here.
起立呼祷平安。
Please arise, greetings of peace.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.